the champion. Fireworks around Wembley.
The damage there first and foremost. Right hand followed by a left. Didn't look really big punches. Bruno taking a long look at him while he was waiting in the neutral corner there. And Guerra's down from that one. That's the right hand again, and this is what the boxing fraternity like to see. A heavyweight who can hit. Count of eight, still in the first round, remember. Bruno setting him up with the left jab there. Down he goes again. Well, that punch seemed to land across the top of the head. And I don't think he wants to get up from that one. And he's out.
Heaven knows the heavyweight scene in this country could do with a lift. And Stevenson folding up on the middle rope and comes out over it. And his foot appears in my face. And he's not going to make it back. No way he's going to make it back, and the crowd are beginning to boo, and he's counted out. Counted out in the first round from what seemed to me to be not very hard punches.
Oh, good punch. Right and left hand, and over goes Gibson, the fourth. And you can't blame him for getting knocked down from those. There were two good punches. Now can Bruno finish it in the fourth? Gibbs hanging on for dear life, but he's going to have to go, I fear. Still trying to fight back, his gum shield's come out. And I think Roland Dakin is going to stop it, and he is in the fourth round.
Good punches left and right. Oh, that was a good combination from Bruno. And he was quick for a big man. Oh, he's only just made it, nine, and he's not too sure of himself now. Bruno could finish this, and he's got him. That's all over. Must be. Sid Nathan steps in, and Tony Moore, for only the sixth time in 55 fights, has been stopped. And Scott already covering up and going down. And looks extremely hurt. Oh, dear. Just over 2 minutes gone. Plenty of time for Bruno to finish this in the first round. And he's got him again. Scott simply can't take his punches. And like one or two opponents already who've met Bruno, they lose heart very quickly. He's had 2 one-round wins already, Bruno. This might be the third. He's still got half a minute to finish it. Scott doing nothing but covering up, and Sid Nathan seen enough. He's decided that Scott is in no fit state to continue, and I don't think Scott wanted to. And so Bruno marks up win number six. Now Bruno knows that he can hurt his man. He won't be looking to stay around too long here in West Berlin. His first fight abroad, and he's impressing the locals. And the Lacusa supporters have suddenly gone very quiet, and they'll be quieter still after that. Left, right. And he doesn't look as though he's going to take much further interest in the proceedings. Nope. I think I'll stay where I am. And very wise too, I would have thought. Counted out in the second round. And so Bruno does it again, and one dissatisfied customer throws his program into the ring.
Oh, he's got it. Started
of the second round, and the Belgian is over, and that might be it for the night, and it is. KO, second round, Bruno does it again, and that is certainly the best opponent he's met, and he has destroyed him in something like 20 seconds.
But to be honest, he's done very little of note since the South African stopped him, and that defeat seems to have sickened him of the game, and that punch, the left hand, will most certainly sicken him again. Round one. Up at seven. A minute to go and he signaled retirement. He can't go on. And if this one goes, he'll go with a real bang, because he is very tall and he weighs just over 16 stone. Oh, there we are. Bang. 35 seconds. And his legs have gone. Oh, it's all over. Quickest yet, 40 seconds on my watch. Acuna's complaining, but his legs have gone. A big right's coming from the big man Bruno. And there's slight worse damage now to Lithgow's left eye. It looks to me as though he may be cut above as well as underneath. And Sid Nathan's being called over. Now, I think they may be calling it a day with trouble around the eye. Denny Mancini, the manager, is asking Nathan to have a look at the damage around that left eye. And I think Mancini is going to call it a day.
That man's ribs are really suffering. He's had enough of it. He's hurt. He's certainly hurt. That really was a damaging body punch. The right hand to the rib cage. He took a headshot afterwards as well.
And met a lot of experienced men like Buckner. Good punches from Bruno, and Allen's taking them well and coming on. But his defenses have gone all over the place. His gum shield's out, and it's stopped in the second round. And Bruno has done it one round faster than Buckner. Bruno upright, a giant. Nielsen a big man, but crouching over and taken with a right hand early in the third. And he looks to his corner, his eyes gone, and Sid Nathan says that'll be enough.
And that eye is looking quite nasty, and Larry O'Connell wants the blood wiped away so he can get a closer look at it. Bruno's gone to a neutral corner. And I think Larry O'Connell is saying he can't go on, and that is exactly what he's saying in the third round.
Bruno's philosophy, despite some of the criticism he takes about stopping men quickly and not gaining the experience, that's what he wants to do. He just likes to stop fights. Down goes punches. It was the uppercut there that did it. And he might not make the count here. Just about recovered, but he doesn't look too healthy. In goes the right hand again, and the referee will stop it. And punches is all over the place.
That was a left hook, and it's taken everything out of Jameson. His leg came up, his right leg came up as he got a hit. And the following punch sent him crashing down. And that, I think, is going to be the end of this fight. Bruno has just shown the American public what he can do with a punch. Lawless is delighted. That is an amazing win. He threw two quick punches and he knocked everything.
Went in with Weaver and he took him to a points decision. But that's 6 years ago.
And over goes Sharkey. Fairly predictably, I would have thought. Flat on his face. And almost certainly flat out. Yes, he is. All over. 2 minutes and 10 seconds on my watch.
Oh, there's the right. He's found him at last. There's the big Bruno right. That's the one he's been saving. And Cummings wishes he'd saved it a bit longer. feet, but his legs have gone and he's counted out. Troy Jumbo Cummings has been stopped for the second time in his life and faster than he's ever been stopped before.
So Bruno's handling himself well here.
Sander was going to make this. He's teetering on the edge of the ring and he's never going to get up from that. The right got him. Well, he's made an effort, but he hasn't beaten the count, and Bruno has knocked him out in the fourth round, and that will do. Thank you very much to wind up 1983 for Frank Bruno.
He's stunned, and he's counted out in, I make it, 67 seconds. Bruno's done it again. That is win number 21 in a row, and the man was simply no match for him.
Berbick was too strong and too experienced for Lacosta. And the first knockdown of the fight in the second round. And Lacosta, for all his durability, doesn't quite know what's hit him, and he may not make it, and he hasn't. It's all over in the second round.
Quite a nasty cut, in a bad place. Nathan giving him every chance. He's seen the cut. He's having a closer look at it now, Sid.
One-way traffic, and Sid Nathan has now seen enough.
He's often accused of being a bit statuesque, Frank, but he's moving around the ring quite snappily at the moment, and he's hurt Rodriguez, and Rodriguez is over with 30 seconds of the first round remaining, and he's badly hurt. Is he going to make it? He's only coming up very slowly at 9, and he can't go on. It's all over. That's amazing.
And this crowd sensing that Bruno could be on the edge of victory here. He's got him again with the right and a second one, and he's down. Right at the start of the fourth round, 10 seconds in. Is he going to beat the count? I don't think he is. He's not coming up, and Bruno is the European champion, and he's made his mark in the world.
Bruno got the big right over the top. Fraser's playing games with him, saying, come on, come to me again.
Sensational. He's not going to get up. He got him underneath with a tremendous left, and he's over and out. Oh, that's amazing. Larry Frazier, count it out.
What a start by Bruno. 55 seconds, a right hand and another. Surely he can't get it over inside a round. Couture's only been stopped twice. He's got him again, he won't get up from that. He's stretched out over the photographers. He'll never make it. He's out, out, out. And Bruno is on his way to a crack at the world title.
That's quite a bit of damage Bruno has wreaked there on the face of Tillis. Tillis's mouth and nose bleeding badly, and he's hurt in the fifth, and he might be going. Bruno can't get a clean shot at him. Tillis is badly hurt and he doesn't want to fight on, and the referee stopped it anyway. And Tillis has got bad damage to his nose and mouth, and Bruno did that with punches.
That's a good punch, and that looks to me as though we may not see any more of Chuck Gardner of Minneapolis tonight. One punch, that's all it took, and he's out, and good enough.
Nowhere else he can get him except the top of his head. Well, this would certainly have been stopped in Britain by now. No question of that. The man's offering almost no resistance except the occasional swing as he comes out of these close quarter exchanges. Groves hands down, standing there just waiting. And it's become a pass.
A long time since Gooden has been asked to cope with a jab like that coming at him. If you look at his opponents over that shot,
yep, and he's down. He clubbed him with a right hand, and he won't go down, Bugner. At that point, he didn't even put the knees on the canvas. He tried to absorb the punches, and that was a pretty brave effort of his, perhaps foolish. And he's getting 7, 8, 9, and he's going to let him box on, and he's pinned in Bruno's corner, and it won't go surely now. The towel has come in from the Australian's corner.
Frank's not a dirty fighter, never was. But it tends to show the sort of pressure there is. And this time a left hand. And I think that will put everything beyond any possible doubt. What a left hand that was. And this time both legs have gone. And Mickey Van is waving it all over.
And Bruno certainly doesn't at the moment anyway look like a 30-year-old who's coming towards the end of a career. He's looking quite young and sprightly.
That's a good right hand, and the man's right above me, and he's almost coming out on top of me. And down goes Levata, and what are people going to say about that? Was that a bum opponent? Everybody said he was a good one. He's knocked out. Round two, Bruno's won again.
Still, amazingly, still finding strength from somewhere. He's the one coming forward. That's a better punch. That hurt him at last. Bruno got through a punch that hurt him. He's come out almost on top of me. He was only saved because two or three people around me helped push him back. And so for the first time in the eighth round, Bruno's right hand suddenly came through, and Kutsia went down. He hasn't been down too many times in his career. And here's the chance for Bruno to bring it all to an end in dramatic fashion. It took him 8 rounds to really get through. And the towel has come in from the South African corner. It's all over. They've pulled Kutsia out of the fight. That's a pretty humane gesture. And it's an amazing fact about Bruno's career that only one fight of his has ever gone the full distance. And that was back in November 1984, a 10-rounder against a man called Phil Brown, and he's got him! Just as I'm talking about a fight going the distance, he pulls the big punch out for the first time. He puts the man on the floor, and Dave Parris has seen enough and stops the fight in the closing round.
And all the scoring punches in these opening couple of minutes coming from Bruno. And Big Jesse is looking a little unsteady on his pins. Oh my word, he's not going to go over in one, is he? He's up at six. Bruno hitting him down on the back of the neck. You get told about that. The rabbit punch, that is illegal. Frank's going for the big win here. He wants to beat Riddick Bowe. And Ferguson is offering nothing in resistance. He's got a lump coming up at the side of his left eye. Ferguson has gone down for the second time. Well, all we can say is that Bruno's going in doing his stuff. Ferguson is woefully vulnerable.
Oh dear. Four on the side of the head.
Three,
there.
Four!
I was hoping it wouldn't happen so quickly that he could have another look at Bruno.
Well, that punch seemed to land in the temple. It was a decent punch, Reg.
Yeah, that one wasn't, Jim. He missed by a mile with that. It's a little bit wild.
Already Bruno's jabs giving him some trouble.
Just turned that into a left hook. His fellow's not going to come up to him. He's not going to make it.
Well, Evans is still there somehow.
Left hook.
That's the third knockdown. Will it be the last? He's wincing, Evans, shaking his head. I don't know if he's going to get up this time. It's over. It's all over in the second round. And that was extremely predictable, it has to be said.
To his credit, sticking to his task, as desperate as it is.
But falling ever further behind him. Oh no! That's what we were worried about. He won't get up from that.
He's out.
A right hand. It's all over.
He's out.
Oh, would you believe it?
Unbelievable.
Would you believe it?